Alright, guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening sa ating mga viewers and to all those watching, no? From the Philippines, of course, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, UAE, lagi naman yan, mga suke. Right, we have also viewers from Taiwan, Singapore, and South Korea. Right, guys, good morning again. Right, so before we start yung ating session, I'd like to share yung ating quick word, no? Napapanahon ngayon. And as you know, Holy Week. Of course, ang ating quick word is from Revelation chapter 7 verse 9. Of course, this pertains, no? Of course, Palm Sunday. And mapabasa din natin dito, no? Na hindi lang din pala dito yan gagawin kung hindi sa after ng buhay natin, no? And at least, no, ito sana yung maging goal natin, to make it to salvation, right, sa heaven, right? Verse read like this, no? After this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palm in their hands. So, ayan, yun, palaspas. So, napakaganda, no? Na, kumbaga sa verse na ito, nakita natin lahat ng klaseng tao, no? So, hindi lang puro Pilipino, kumbaga may mga ibang lahi din na nandoon. And, hopefully, no? Everyone, no? Desires na, kumbaga sa ano, masave, of course, no? Nababanggit dito yung the Lamb. Of course, alam naman natin yan, no? The Lamb is pertains to Jesus Christ na nag-sacrifice, right? Para matubos tayo, no? Purchased by the blood. And yun yung paraan, eh, no? Para tayo may save. And without shedding of that blood, hindi tayo, kumbaga sa ano, kumbaga maliligaw tayo or hindi tayo masisave. Alright? So again, no, napakaganda nung message of salvation. Right. So palm, of course, the symbols yung triumph, victory, right? Na finally, no, na overcome yung sin and death. Right? So guys, very timely, and of course, I hope that I am being helped sa inyo, no? At least makarinig kayo ng mga ganitong ano, mga verses na usually we don't hear from the church. Eh, at least, no, yung sa from my point of view, no, simpleng-simple lang naman akong individual, but at least, no, na at least, no, I am a witness to you na talagang kumbaga kung gaano ka-importante itong reading of the Bible. So again, I encourage you again and again to read your Bible and to meditate upon it, and maganda yung mga mensahe, no? And of course, no, right, so again, at this point in time, anything that I would say, take it with a grain of salt, right? The final decision, ikaw pa rin yung magbabuy and sell. So again, kung gusto mo ng 100%, of course, guys, yung Bible, nandoon, no? That is contains the truth. And anything at this point na sasabihin ko, it is just a mere probability, alright? So, most likely, sablay pa, or kumbaga sa ano, magkamali. Malaking chance sa magkamali, or kahit 50-50. So again, be very, very careful with the market today, right? So, we're going to start yung ating review, of course, ating weekly observations. Right, so again, for the PSEi, we gain yung 7 points. So, I think not that bad, no? Considering the fact na we have a market slowdown, especially liquidity ng market, medyo mahina ngayon, no? So, we did close at 7,880. And of course, weak rally overall. And, no? Few strong names left. And, you might not well believe it, no? Pero mas maganda yung nakikita ko sa ating market. Of course, medyo slowdown ngayon, and next week we will have very, very short trading day, no? I think hanggang Wednesday lang yung trading. And then holiday na ng Thursday and Friday, of course. Dapat lang. Solemn kasi yung mga araw na yon. Alright. So again, PSEi natin, we're seeing, no? Solid support at least kahit sa Monday to Tuesday and Wednesday, we see this being touched, no? Yung 7,800 area. Nakita natin, no? Of course, last week, we were really bullish, no? Na malalampasan natin itong resistance area na to, but it did not happen. Of course, sa nakikita natin, I think 8,000 to 8,100 yung ating target pa rin, no? Up to this point, we cannot really say kung if magko-continue yan, no? So, at the very least, I am bullish, no? At least for the second quarter. Yung ating, of course, nag-start na April, May, and June. And then, of course, ano yung nakikita ko after the break? I think, no? From what we're seeing yung sa price action, I think by after the break, siguro, I think, magiging sideways yung market, no? And I think magre-resume yan. Siguro, no? At least, siguro, mga first, second week magpipick up, no? So, hindi ko nagustuhan kasi yung naging formation ng price action dito. But on the short term, if you are looking for that 3-month long period, short term bullish, no? Because of this volume pa rin dito, no? So, ibig sabihin may nagkapwestuhan and maganda pa rin naman, no? At least for the short term, no? But after the break April, I do not think magrarally ng mabilis. I think magkakaroon pa ng mga sideways movement, no? Doon sa 7,800 area. And then come May or June, doon na tingin ko sisipa, no? So again, not necessarily mangyayari yon, but of course, we're just basing our analysis sa current market, no? And yung surprise action na pinapakita. So next, of course, ang ating move of the week, I think Monday last week to, we have yung 14% movement. Ito yon sa surpass. Alright, sa surpass, nag-spike up siya, no? I hope na nahuli nyo to. Ako, naka-ride ako rito, no? Pag-spike dito. So, we're seeing resistance sa 135-139 area. And I think, no? Sa mukhang bababa ulit to sa support na 109-114. So at least doon ka mag-abang ulit. Overall, medyo hirap yung surpass. Of course, magkaroon ng mga recent changes sa kanyang administration and sa mga officers nito. But medyo hirap. Right? So marami na frustrate dito sa area na to. And then nag-breakdown nga dito sa support. And finally, on another level. No? But at least, no? Again, abang-abang lang sa 109-114. Baka magkaroon ng mini double bottom, no? At least maganda yung pwestuhan yun. Okay. Surpass. So, kumbaga sa ano, medyo mahirap i-trade to eh. Kasi you might be up one day and then you might be down big on another day. So, at least manage your position and yung risk. Right? Yung size, of course. Like kung sinasabi for the last 3 weeks na medyo maging maingat sa sizing. So, next on our watch list would be the sentiment of the market. I think for this week, no? At least observe ulit. And of course, nakikita naman natin, no? Throughout the week, very low yung turnover value, no? Of course, especially dun sa mga non-index stock. Napakababa ng turnover. Minsan, below 100,000 pa. May mga nakikita ka sa top 10. And sa mga stocks, no? So again, so ngayon, no? Ngayon yung market, kumbaga sa ano, ito yung time to slow down. Ito yung time, no? At least to reflect, no? Yung inyong trading and yung mga nagawang mali, no? And one of the few things, no? Na at least makukuha mo rito sa video na to. Isang market, para siyang stop dance, no? Remember yung mga party, yung mga stop dance ng bata. Baka ikaw yung trade pa rin ng trade na hanggang ngayon. And then the overall market, yung tugtog wala. So, kapag medyo wala yung tugtog, huwag ka masyadong bira ng bira ngayon, no? of course, sasabay mo, no? Isasabay mo yung inyong aggressiveness kapag ka maganda yung market. And then, pagka ganitong medyo tame down yung market, medyo kumbaga sa ano, yung activity mo, medyo bababa din. And then, yung mga trades mo, you will be selective, no? So, I think that's one of the few things, no, na overlook ng most of the traders, if not lahat tayo nagdaan dyan. So again, yung ating sentiment would be observe, and sa nakikita natin, no, maganda yung naging build up nitong tatlong stocks na to. Dapat, no, dapat ngayon nagko-consolidate sila or humihina, but right now we're seeing strength dito, no, especially dito sa mga names na to, SMC, ALI, and FB. Lalo na itong ALI, I think for the whole week yata, if I'm not mistaken, top traded value siya, no? Laging number one siya sa activity or yung number of turnover pagdating sa value, no? While SMC and FB, we're seeing, no, na yung it's currently knocking, no, sa kanyang 52-week high. Alright, so again, we're going to give yung mga names na we should be watching, and of course, no, yung inyong entries and exit, especially, no, right now yung inyong sizing and position would be critical part, no, kung magiging profitable ka or hindi, no. And right now, no, for this year, kung ma-maintain ko yung aking performance or yung aking percentage, I think, no, baka probably I will be able to breach yung triple digit returns. And hindi pa naman yung sigurado, especially if mag 8-1 tayo or above 8-5, I think mas madaling kunin yun. So ako medyo, kumbaga sa ano ngayon, medyo defensive ako. Of course, whole seam, ano ba yung nakikita natin dito? This is a clear base. Base 1, base 2. And I think, no, parang nagta-transition siya from base 2 to base 3. Of course, hanggat hindi nababasag tong support na to, which is around 1060 to 1094, no, at least we're good, no. And right now, we don't ask too much dito sa whole sim, at least for the Monday to Wednesday, at least mag-consolidate lang muna diyan sa area na 'yan. And then after the break na rin natin makikitang sumipa, no. Magusto ko rito, maganda yung activity, no. I think there's still accumulation na nagaganap, and they're currently kicking yung mga traders na medyo naiinip and yung gusto ng action, kumbaga sa ano, ito yung time na binibili nila, no. But right now, we don't see it slowing down. Again, manage your position. Magdagdag, no. Habang tumataas, you see another break. Magdagdag, alright. So, ipiramid mo lang, especially yung mga ganito na medyo safe, no. All seem overall, bukod dun sa kanyang maganda kasi, no, yung fundamental news niya. We see yung tax break, I think, and yung import taxes naman sa mga kalaban niya. So two-way sword, no. And then we see yung CHP nag-struggle, no. So para kumbaga sa ano, dito na pupunta sa whole sim yung attention ng mga fund managers, no. So I think this is been on our watch list, no, for at least 2 weeks na. So, next on our watch list, SMC, of course, nagpakita na naman to. Yung big spike in volume. And then, we're seeing, no, na sa resistance area, it's finally, knocking, no, sa resistance area. And I think once it breaks, especially mga 184, 185, that's a good signal for us, no? Mapapansin nyo yung mga spike ng volume ngayon. Ito yung naging setup, no? Usually, nakikita ko to once per month, no, yung ano ito, pero last week medyo marami ako nakita na yung mga volume spikes nila finally did confirm. And ang maganda pa ron, these are quality names, no. Again, for San Miguel, I think may mga offerings to sa kanyang mga future projects, but I think they're anticipating, no, na yun ang magiging kumbaga sa ano, yung wind at the back nitong San Miguel, no. And I think, no, yung kanyang all-time high would be around, I think, 190. Multi-year. So, I think there's a good chance, no, na itong San Miguel finally breaking yung 180 level. and finally moving up, no? So let's see, no? Mukhang maganda yung pinapakita itong San Miguel. Very reliable yung kanyang chart. Maganda on the uptrend. We're seeing din yung triangle dito. Parang ready to get out of the box immediately, no? So again, next on our watch list would be FB, of course. Sister company niya would be FB. Again, same setup. We're seeing yung big spike in volume. And then we're seeing na it is knocking, no? It is knocking on the resistance, which is currently set to 112 area, no? So again, if we see, no, na mag-break itong 112 area, we're going to definitely consider itong FB. And maganda kasi, no, kung mapapansin nyo, FB and SMC are locally, kumbaga parang locally dominated, no? So yung mga buyers niya, usually yung mga locals, malaki yung, tapos, mapapansin nyo rin, ngayon binibili, no? Kung kailan yung market very slow, ngayon binibili kasi alam nila na yung mga retails are busy with the vacation, busy with the Holy Week, no? So simply observation lang, no? Nagpakita rin, no? Finally did confirm, nakita ko na to dati, but right now, last week lang nag-confirm yung SMC and FB. And mapapansin nyo, we're finally seeing na nagkaroon ng rotation na naman, no? We're seeing noise and uncertainty pagdating sa AGI, which has been on our watch list, I think, for months now. And even yung ICT, finally nakikita natin, medyo nagcha-choppy. And then we're seeing yung SMC and FB finally knocking on the lead, and parang kumbaga sa ano, nagpaparamdam, no? So again, I really expect this stock, no, at least to trend for the next quarter. So isa pa, etong Wilcon, no? Again, yun na naman, big spike in volume. And then finally last week din nag-confirm din, no? But maganda kasi dito sa Wilcon, if you remember it right, no? Yung beginning of the year, mga January, isa to sa tatlo na nag-lead, eh, no? Ang nag-lead noon ng January, SLI, FGen, and Wilcon. Alright, SLI, maganda yung chart, uptrend din, but medyo kumbaga sa ano, liquidity, mahina. So FGen, medyo naging choppy. I think last month pa yung nag-choppy and nag-consolidate. And then right now, Wilcon, nag-confirm din, no? So again, napansin nyo na naman, no? Yung kanyang big spike in volume. Yun kasi, no, yung mood setting. Pag may mga ganyan malalaking touring green na ganyan, talagang kumbaga sa ano, it dictates, no? It dictates bullishness. And not last but not least, no? I mean, eh yung ALI, no? ALI finally break yung hirap na hirap yan, yung 45 level. Currently, nag-close siya dito sa 46.60. Alright, napansin mo, yung big spike in volume na naman, no? Overshadowing lahat, no? And then finally breaking yung 45, yung 52 week high niya. Nahirap na hirap siya, no? For the last 3 months, hindi siya makaano doon, no? Napapayungan siya. Finally did break. And then, maganda rito, no? For the last, I think, for the last week, intense yung accumulation, eh, no? So simpleng analysis lang yan. Tulad ng sinasabi ko sa inyo, at least for the next 3 months I'm still bullish, no? Makita niyo naman yung mga names na naglalabasan ngayon. Dapat kasi ano sila ngayon, tahimik, no? Pero naglalabasan sa mga ranges nila. So that is a sign na ano yung mga mangyayari, at least, no, for the next quarter. And until we see yung 81 mabasag, at least, no, to be safe, manage your size and your entries. So of course, that's it for today, and I hope you learned something, and please take note, no, yung mga ating mga watch list. And maraming salamat again. Please hit that like that button, and of course, no, you might want to subscribe for the weekly updates. Again, maraming salamat sa panonood. This is PSEi Recap.